is that he had to empower himself as far as the concept of God is concerned. Don't leave Allah in your mind. Or don't leave Allah in your tongue. They asked Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam, what is the consequence of leaving Allah in the tongue or having the idea of Allah in our mind? And the Imam said, you make a lot of mistakes. You take mistakes lightly. Because Allah is not deeply rooted in you. Today, we argue with ourselves to say, let me go and do it. Allah is merciful. Allah will forgive me. Because you have a particular assumption of this God. يَزُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ زَنَّ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. That is, our understanding of Allah is very ignorant. يَزُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ زَنَّ السُّوءِ. That is, our thinking when it comes to Allah and the concept of Allah is evil. So the first level of Tawheed is the common level of Tawheed that you find. Allah is in our tongue. Allah is just a concept. That is why it's possible that you can be a Muslim, you kill. You still want to call yourself a Muslim, but want to kill. You still want to call yourself a Muslim, but want to cheat. If somebody says you are not a Muslim, you are willing to fight. So Imam al-Sadiq says, yeah, he is a Muslim, but the level of his tawheed, the level of his understanding about the concept of God is low. Are we together? So Tawheed should not remain in your tongue. Tawheed should not just be a mere concept. Now this is the second level of Tawheed. The best level of Tawheed. Salawat. Maybe before to go to this, what do you call it, the highest level of Tawheed, you ask yourself, when you wake up in the morning until evening, how many mistakes have you done? And some of the mistakes, you know them, but you still do them. And then you still relate yourself to Tawheed. Allahu Akbar, that's a problem. Now let's look at the second level of Tawheed. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam said, number one, this level of Tawheed is in the blood. It's not in the tongue. It's not just a mere concept. It is in the blood. What does it mean to have something in your blood? Number two, Imam al-Sadiq says, the highest level of Tawheed is in the flesh. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
And Imam al-Sadiq said, if you have Tawheed, if you have God in your blood, if you have God in your flesh, you don't take sins lightly because God is in your existence. You become mindful. You become mindful, not like the one who have Tawheed in his tongue. Or not like the one who have Tawheed on the topi and the kurta. Allah. Wallahi. So now Imam al-Sadiq further explained the Tawheed that is in the blood and in the flesh. He refers us to Dua'u Nudba. For those of you who are familiar with Dua Unudba, this Dua is read or recited every Friday to praise Ali Muhammad alayhi wassalatu wassalam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
When the Prophet talked about Imam Ali, he said, wal imanu mukhalitun lahmak wa damak. That is, the belief of Allah is mixed with your blood and your flesh. كَمَا خَالَتَ لَحْمِي وَدَمِي. Just like the belief in Allah is mixed with my flesh and my blood. SubhanAllah. So now compare the two levels of Tawheed. So you see, this is the level of Ahlul Bayt. When they speak about God, the God is in their flesh and their blood. Hence, they qualify to become what? A ma'sumun, subhanAllah. When you and I speak about God, it is laklakatul lisan. It remains in our tongue. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Today we're speaking about Ashura, the battle between Imam Hussein and Yazid. Yazid never said to anyone that is not a Muslim, Imam alayhi salatu wassalam is the leader of the Muslim, but both people are on Tawheed. So you ask yourself, which Tawheed is this guy talking about? And which God is Imam alayhi salatu wassalam talking about? You realize this camp has God, but they are willing to kill. Not just to kill, but to kill the son of the messenger. And you see the camp of Imam Hussein talking about concept of God. But you see the behavior that is being displayed. So this is a very important concept. During the time of the Prophet, the Arabs, they say, "Qalatul a'rabu amanna." And then the Arab says, "We believe in Allah." The revelation came to say, "Qul lam tu'minu." Muhammad, tell them that is the idea of Tawheed has not set in them. The idea of Tawheed is just a concept. The idea of Tawheed is just in our mouth. Allahu Akbar. So check your behavior. Ask yourself this question: is Tawheed in my blood? Is Tawheed in my flesh? And then you will get the answer why you behave the way you are behaving. Why you treat your mother the way you treat your mother. Why you treat people the way you treat people. SubhanAllah. Salawat. So theologically, spiritually, these are some of the glimpses. These are some of the points Wallahi Ashura, Muharram tells us. Muharram is holy. During Jahiliyyah, before Islam, even the people will not fight. But Yazid chose this month to kill Imam Hussein. That's another point. Okay, let's go to the second point. I said in the beginning that Muharram, Karbala, and Ashura is a moral template. How many of us will graduate in the school of Muharram and be morally upright and have ahlak? But how many Muharram and how many Ashura has come and gone in your life? How has Muharram and Ashura changed your life? Changed your thinking? Morality was displayed until the 10th of Ashura and beyond. Look at Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wassalam. When he left Medina, he told all his neighbor. And today, if you are living in your community, and I mean, what is your relationship with your neighbors? It's either they don't trust you or you don't trust them. Salawat. True. I'm telling you, this is a sad reality. Wallahi, the Khalifatullah, the son of Allah, the Habibullah, the most important people, he goes to house and house. And the hadith, according to Imam Sadiq, 40 people from your right have right upon you. From your left have right, from your back have right over you. Not in our time. I'm telling you, even the closest neighbor, wallahi, you curse one another, you make love on one another. Wallahi, this is the kind of world we are in. So Imam leave. The second morality that we learn, Imam did not take a step without his family. save yourself and save your family from hell. In fact, Imam Hussein died. Wallahi, with his family. You don't move an inch without your family. These are some of the things that Imam is telling us. Look at our society. It is so easy to compromise your family. It is so easy to give your family Allahu Akbar Kabira. And today, Islam is also used to justify, you know, certain evil that we see in our family.